Hello everyone. Today we are going to look at how to control NodeMCU using Google Assistant. Okay. So the aim of this experiment is to control home appliances using Google Assistant. So here I have mentioned home appliances, but in the experiment we are going to control the LED which is connected to NodeMCU. So the components required. So we have NodeMCU and we need LED and a 330 ohms resistor as well as breadboard and some jumper wires. So this is the schematic or connections diagram, and the circuit is already connected as per the given diagram. So D2 is the LED is connected to the pin D2, and this is the overall architecture of this experiment. So in this program we are going to use the MQTT protocol, message queue telemetry transport protocol. So according to this protocol, there are three main entities. One is publisher, which publishes data or sends data, and the broker, which maintains the data in the form of topics, and the subscriber, which consumes the data from the broker by subscribing to a topic. So the topic looks like this. So we have different levels which are separated by forward slashes. So this is an example for topic. Okay. So in our example, the publisher will be the Google Assistant from the mobile phone, which sends some voice messages, and the broker will accept those messages and store the data in the form of topics. And based on the message itself, this broker is going to send values to NodeMCU. Once the NodeMCU gets the values by subscribing to the topic, it will do some actions, like in this case turning on and off the LED. Okay, so before going to look at code, we have to do some steps here. So first of all, let me go to Firefox. Open a browser and go to the website called ivo.adafruit.com. Create an account on this website. I already logged in using my username and password. So otherwise, here at the top right hand corner you will see a link called Get Started. When you click that link, you can create an account. So anyway, I have logged into the account. And the first thing you have to take care is, when you click this My Key, you are going to get an authentication key for your account. Copy that key somewhere. We have to use that key in the program. And you will see this interface when you logged in. When you are logged in, you will see a button called New Dashboard. Click that. Give some name to your dashboard. You can give anything. I am giving Test 1. Create. Okay, so the new I have just created a new dashboard by the name test1. So click this link, test1. So it's open. Go to the right hand side and click on this drop down, and let's turn off the dark mode. It's kind of distracting. And now you have to click on create new block. Okay, so you will get different kinds of things that you can create as blocks. I will be using this toggle switch on and off. So there are already two topics that I have created previously. So you will not see these things. You have to create a new one. Let's say I am giving light 2. Create. Okay, it is created. Now you have to select that thing which you have created now and go to next step. Okay, so block title here, it is optional. You can leave it like that. And the text you give here appears here, okay, on the bottom. And you can leave this as it is, and you can click on create block. Okay, your block is created. Now, one thing you have to remember is you have to find the topic URL. For that, again, click the drop down here and click on edit layout. Now you got a gear symbol here. Click on the gear symbol. Now go to block info. Okay, so here you can find your topic name. Okay, so here you will get your username and then feeds, and after that the topic name you have given in the previous step. Okay, so you have to remember this. Okay, so one part of the things we have to do is completed. Next one is go to another website called ifttt.com. So it means if this then that. Okay, so again click on login. Okay, so go down and click on this, continue with Apple, Google or Facebook. So I am going to click on continue with Google. And one thing you have to remember is, since we will be using Google Assistant on the mobile phone, you have to use the same email that you are using for Google Assistant to log in into ifttt.com. So I am using the same email ID. I am already logged into Google, so it won't ask me username and password. Okay, it connected to my account. Okay, so the thing you will see is this one, my applets. So every free user has the ability to create 3 applets. So I already created 2. So one of them is for turning on the lights, another one is to turn off the lights. So I will show you an example how to create this. So just click on the plus symbol for creating an applet. Okay, first you will see this one, if this, then click on this add button. Okay, in the search box, just type Google and you will see Google Assistant, select Google Assistant. And we are going to give some voice commands. So I am going to select say a simple phrase. Click on that. And you can type whatever command you want to say. I am saying turn lights on. And another way of saying the same thing. For example, turn on lights, or one more option, lights on. So when you give any one of these 3 comments, the data is going to be submitted to Adafruit, which we will see in a few seconds. And here you can type the response that the assistant will give you when you give the voice command, one of the above 3 comments. So let's say the assistant will say turning on lights. Okay, you can select the language and click on create trigger button like this. Okay, so the first part is completed, and the second part is we must say what should be taking place when we give some voice command. So click on this add button. Okay, now search for Adafruit. So click on this. I have already logged into my Adafruit account. So Let's see. You have to click this send data to Adafruit IO. Just click it. And now it is asking to which feed it has to submit. Okay, so I have created light 2 just now. So I can select this. And what data you want to save? So previously I gave the command turning lights on. So I will send the number 1. Okay, so NodeMCU is going to receive this 1, and based on this I am going to turn on and off the LED. So just click on create action. So that's all you have to do. And once you create this, once you click on this create action, a new applet will be created. So I am not going to click on that, since I already created both the applets. So it's still loading. Okay, so if you successfully created the applet, so you will see blocks like this. So I created one applet for turning on the lights and one more applet for turning off the lights. Okay, let's go back to the slide. So let's look at the code. So importing Wi-Fi library, importing Adafruit's MQTT library along with MQTT client library, and we are setting the LED pin to D2. Change this SSID to your Wi-Fi SSID, and change this password to your Wi-Fi password. And you need to change this username to your respective username on Adafruit website, and I already told you to save the authentication key, so replace this API key with your Adafruit authentication key. Okay, that's all. These are the changes you have to do in the program, and we are creating Wi-Fi clients, and we are creating MQTT object using the Adafruit's MQTT client library, and we are sending the server name, server port number, your Adafruit username, and Adafruit authentication key. If you remember, all these values are coming from these constants, okay, named constants. And then we are subscribing to the feed. If you remember, I told you to remember this path, right? So your Adafruit username followed by feeds slash the topic or feed name that you have given. So previously I have shown you, I have created a new feed called light 2. So you have to give that thing here. You have to change this. Okay. And we are using the function MQTT connect. And now the setup function, where we are trying to connect to the Wi-Fi. So once the Wi-Fi is successfully connected, we are displaying the IP address of NodeMCU, and then we are using the function subscribe. Okay, right. And then one more function loop, where we are calling MQTT underscore connect function. We will see the code for this in the next slide. And then we are using the subscription variable here, and using that we are going to retrieve the values. Either 1 or 0 will be coming based on the voice command, like I have shown you in the ifttt.com website. And okay, so we are turning on or turning off the LED based on the value that is returned by Adafruit. So here is the code for the function MQTT underscore connect. So what we will be doing in this code is, we are trying to connect to the MQTT service on Adafruit. So here it will be retrying for the connection for 3 times. So if it is connected, it will display MQTT connected. Otherwise, it will retry for 3 times. So these are the steps that need to be followed, which I have already shown you. First, you need to create an account on Adafruit.io. You have to create a dashboard and then add a blog. And then you need to create a feed. And then you log into ifttt.com. And you have to use the same Google account which you will be using for using with Google Assistant. And then you have to install Adafruit MQTT library in the Arduino. Okay, so just search in Google for how to install this Adafruit MQTT library. You'll see that you will get the steps needed, and then we will upload the program onto NodeMCU, and then I will show you this open Google Assistant and giving the voice command. So let's move on to Arduino. So okay, the program is compiled. Now the program is being uploaded onto NodeMCU. So let me open the serial monitor. Okay, the program is running and NodeMCU is connecting to my Wi-Fi hotspot. Okay, it got the IP address. Okay, now it's connected to MQTT. Let me open the Google Assistant in my mobile.
Here are some.
Okay, Google, lights on.
Turning on light.
Okay, now you can see the LED is on. Okay, Google, lights off.
Turning off light.
Okay, now the LED is off. I will repeat this. Okay, Google, lights on.
Turning on light.
Okay, you can see LED is on. Okay, Google, lights off.
Turning off light.
Okay, now the LED is off. Also, you can see in the serial monitor, whenever I am giving voice command, the corresponding data value is being retrieved and shown here. Okay, so this is how you control NodeMCU using Google Assistant. Thank you.